Hi, Tech Rabbit here. Some more tools for the makerspace. It's a table saw. It's the brand Parkside. It's a brand usually carried around in our region by a supermarket chain called Lidl, and they sometimes stock these and sometimes don't. They use these as products to attract customers to come buy other stuff. And this is one of the biggest packages that I've unboxed and assembled and tested. So we'll see how the documentation of this will work. I was thinking maybe we try to get all the individual parts out and identified, and then we can probably see how we can document the process of putting it together. So let's open up and see what we can find. Those must be the tabletops, the side tables. One plate. A little bit. Well, let's see what we find here. A bracket, two brackets. I'm going to be sawing that blade. Doesn't look that bad, and it's quite heavy. Probably the thing to do with the laser. bolts. These look like feet.
What?
That's the rubber for the feet.
Yes, exactly. You don't want feet.
Feet. Like the floor. Now this is probably the dust collecting bag, I would assume. Okay. Or garbage collecting bag. Let's see, we'll look at the assembly instructions. Okay, another table, so there's three tables. Like the main table's in here. The main table's in the box upside down, and that's the one that turns the way that looks like it. One more. And blade protection. This is, should be the guide, I suppose. We'll see. Ah, the aluminium part of it. Also, as part of the table. Okay, I think I'll try and tip up the view here. So that's the main unit in the box. Well, I think I will. What we'll do now is I'll pause the video and get this main unit out of the box. I don't think there's any parts as such left hanging in there. If there is not, that's not the guide aluminium, but there's any other parts. Maybe on the other side. Might be more parts. Let's take a check. Oh, look, some more parts. More stands. More supports. Oh, this is really heavy. Gee, what the heck's this? Okay, that's a bunch of leg bits. No problem, these are to assemble the legs. More ports to assemble the legs. Okay, is that now everything? Oh, another question is how to get this out of the box. Underneath. should have folded that in, of course. Oh, let's go. There. Okay, so now we can slide this. Ah, but it's got a blade in it. Sorry about that blinking. That's my cell phone. I should have turned off the sound. Let's see. Oh, I thought it would slide out. I'm making a mess of this. Should just cut the box off. Just that my son wants to play with the box. Said he wants the box. So then I can't destroy it. There! Out, but that's fine. What is it? Okay, so that's a more coarsed tooth. Blade is in here already. Looks like one can choose. Oh, no idea how I want this set up. And then you get this one, a little bit different teething. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is just read up on the safety instructions, guarantee, I don't care. I will look through this and come back very soon. Okay, I got it out of the box. Had to actually turn it around. It's supposed to be assembled upside down according to the instruction. Also, one thing I noticed is if one wants to prevent the motor from flipping or flopping around, then one should crank it up to the zero level. And then here's a locking screw. Just lock that down and then the motor won't go flip-flop. So, let's see the instructions. I don't remember what to do here. Okay, looks like we take. Legs first, I suppose. Oh, I read this one. The numbering is a bit confusing.
make the assumption that 25 means 25. Should be the, why is it saying, why is it pointing at the holes then? That's not even a number or screw. Really not sure what they mean by this knock. 21. Anyway, there's four of these main feet, so I'm assuming these go here. I'm not really understanding. These parts. A knife to open it. That's the side supports. Can get the whole process in the frame here. That's so high up. I hope they get the idea. So these will go on this, I would assume. looks like it goes on the inside. It's like I'm not really feeling awake tonight. Or today, actually. It's not even evening. I've had some coffee, so I shouldn't be so dumb as I am now. No, but that should go on there. Why is it not onto the slip button? Trying to put them all on, not them falling down. Without any screws in it. Nobody touch. Let's see. I need to have some screws. Yes.
box to sort the screws. Anyway, so far, so good. So, four legs, then the four cross supports. And that needs to be screwed together. Sort the nuts and bolts off. Well, I'm tiny here, I might make it a bit easier to put together. Yes, there is. I have it distributed them into two different bags, and they're exactly the same length. That's so strange. Not actually clearly marked which is which. So that's that. So now we have all the nuts and bolts sorted a little bit better. Now let's see what we're going to use here. We need to have B. That's like the first collection of I'll just hand tighten it now. Let's see now. So I am assuming that they need to be inserted from the outside in.
flat washer locking spring. Probably one reason why I'm not thinking straight. It's actually quite warm in the garage today. Oof! Pretty much close to 28 Celsius, 29. If you can see the fan, I have a fan here on the side. Okay, so let's tighten your hand tighten. It's getting towards the limit of what the camera lens can handle. It's kind of hard to get everything in frame. I'd like to get some more gloss, but it's pretty expensive. I have to make the channel grow to a million subscribers and I can get some sponsorships. Okay, a bit fast forward. It was worth showing all the bolts and nuts and washers and all. But anyway, I'll put them in place and I'm going to show in this corner here what I've been doing is to make sure that these two pieces are together. Push them together and then it's a 10 millimeter spanner to tighten the bolt down. Same on this side, so I'll tighten that down. Just make sure they stay together. So, it's like that. Let's see if we can try and look at the picture. Okay, so now we've done that part. This I don't understand. First they say to screw it in, and then they say don't screw it in. So it's like one should do, according to the text, one should do like 5, 7, and then possibly 6. Oh.
Now the picture on the text doesn't match. At least in the Swedish translation, the text of the instruction does not follow the pictures, the order of the pictures. But anyway, let's do whatever we want to do. Yeah. Let me just continue. What would make most sense to do next time? Putting the feet on. Sometimes feet are difficult to get on. We can put the back supports on. Stop it from being flipped over. Because this is aluminium and plastic, so it's not a very heavy unit. So if it would, in theory, be doing long cuts, then you risk pushing it over. And these need to be on the back side. Which in our case is the levers on the front, so that's the back side is over there. Same.
same sort of just not quite. Do the magical video trick and be back when I'm done with those. So, back again. Just tighten these up. Ah. Just need to hold them a bit to keep them up. Twist the alignment. So, it's done. Well, as I said, pictures and text don't follow each other. I want to mess this instruction. So we need to have the table. Table supports, side table supports aren't needed. Short ones and long ones. So there's two of the longer ones there for the back table. So that must be Okay. This one. Recognize, what is the back to the back. That's obvious. There's screw holes on the actual table unit. Okay, anyway, those will then get the whole thing in the front. And these will belong. Okay. So that should be side table. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay. So these are these bolts. And what we do is we short ones for the side table. They need to be, so you need to like bolt through there and then to the machine. Oops, no cross threading. Front, they don't actually don't have a leg here or here. So screw into bolts. That one, and then this one, the side one with the stand, the little short stand on it. I actually don't know if I should tighten it down because I probably have to lower the table. I think I'll leave that to tighten it. Thank you.
very tight threads. At least on those. Oh, this one might be a bit easier. So the next step is to put the next two short ones on, and then the back will be the two long ones, and then I have to reposition this a bit. So, video magic. Okay, now we'll try and get the side table, or the tables, the surfaces that go around. So here's one of the side tables. Because the measurement thing is there, so that should come to the end in the same way. So that should go up. Doesn't look correct at all. No, wait, right, left. So that's probably the wrong. Thing with having this on a flat surface, this now we should just screw those in. And it's these bolts. Probably going to need another spanner. Because this one. Dig out my other spanners. Classical should have been a prepared. So where have I put it? I always put tools back.
Okay.
does come with its own tools. Maybe we can use that.
Oh, I was actually used
the tool package that came with the unit. Find my spanner later. Probably used it for another project. It's probably just tucked away in some box. Set. Hoping that was the way it should be on the inside, but that would make more sense. According to the picture, it looks like that should be on the inside. So. Oh, that's one side, or yeah, one table piece in place. So now I'm just going to do the other side the same way, and then the back one should go in the same way. So I'll use the magic of video again to get it done.
Okay, that's the tables on. The side table, and there's another one on the other side, of course. And then this is the back table with the supports in place. And now I have to, for the next phase, I need to get this off the table onto the ground. So we will see. If I don't come back, I'm probably underneath it. Okay, now I got it down from the table. And then you're probably wondering why I have the packing box set up on the table. And this is just to show one thing, one problem that I found. Is that there's this, when you have the actual cutting blade and then you have the guide divider at the back. It's been, because they didn't lock down the, like in the earlier in the video when I was saying that this, the motor gimbal was not locked in place. So what's happened is that you can see from the packing case that this here has been hitting on the bottom as the box has been going up and down, and it led to the fact that this got twisted out of alignment. The actual guide. So what I did is I took the right aluminium piece and then set it against the blade, and I tried to, or I straightened this as best I could, and I think it's good enough. The tolerances are not that huge on these things anyway. But anyway, just check that when you have it, because if this is too far out of alignment and you start sawing things, then you can get into jamming situations and you can get saw kickback and stuff, so that's not that much fun. But anyway, moving on to the next phase. So okay, let's see what other parts we need to put on. Really won't give up. Thank you. screw. Not that obvious how one opens this up. A little bit more difficult than I thought. Okay, well, they could have made the finger holder a little bit more positive. Okay. I'll just put the batteries in. Screw it back in. This really doesn't really take. Okay, that's the, and that should be in there, I suppose. Screws this double side. We should put it like this. Thank you.
probably needs to be a bit adjusted. As need be. I'll just leave it there for now. I don't really trust laser stuff anyway. Let's see if this is slipping back. Laser in place, and then it had an instruction to make a clearance adjustment between the guide and the saw blade, but it's basically it's already set up for the blade that's in there, so I don't think we need to open this for now. I might make, probably going to make a follow-up video on changing the blade to this one, and then we can cover it though. Anyway, now we make a cover. Ah, and that just basically sits on. Its place, and then yeah, that's neat. Okay. And there's no further picture instructions. This can be adjusted. We'll put it into different positions, I'm assuming, based on what kind of saw I want to. Well, I'll just put it there in default location for now. This move to that one. So I'm going to switch between the two. There's the back. Which I'm assuming, not really exactly sure what the bag is for. So to put garbage in. No real good picture of how it's should be installed. Oh. Yeah, it should go on like that. So let's see how many bolts we have left. Exactly 4. Or does it hang on those bolts? They're not supposed to be. Could make sense that one can just put it on and take it off. Okay, so one, if I understand correctly, I don't know if one can actually see with the camera so well. I need to reposition the camera a bit. Okay. So then one takes one of these bolts and one puts it through, and then one has two nuts that one can put on. So that's the way, and then there'll be 4 of them, one there, one here, and one here. Gotta use the magic of video to do this one. Okay, that's the bag installed. So you can see the 4 bolts. Oh, it's quite good. Probably lost a while. And now I've already plugged it in. And I can just start it up and see if the blade turns. Where I currently have it, I can't actually do any real sawing because of the mess it will create, so I'm gonna have to make a follow-up video showing making some cuts, but I'll be doing projects, so that probably won't be too far in the future. Good to have ear protection. Let's see if it actually starts. That actually sounds pretty nice. As far as I've been listening to Salt. Could be a bit tighter, this is going to flop around. As I said, I don't really know if lasers are that useful. I usually don't use them. Put it in place. Okay, well that's done it. I would say maybe a bit too big a piece of equipment to do. To assembly in the area that I have available. I also have to, now I've actually built myself into a corner, as they say. So now I actually have to try and get this moved to the location I would like to have it in. And yeah, wish me luck that I don't have to disassemble the whole thing. And yeah, stuff like that. Anyway, if you like this video, consider subscribing. Hit the bell button if you want to be notified of new videos. I will be continuing creating project videos and tool assembly videos as I build up the maker workshop a bit better. Anyway, I think this was quite fun. I'll see you in the next one then.